When you give a product to a person, they give it a life. I'm not really designing for me, I'm designing, you're designing something and you're setting up a structure and you're putting it into the world, and then people bring it to life, people create the narrative. I'm Francis Bitonti, I'm the founder of Francis Bitonti Studio. I'm a designer and we're here in my studio in Brooklyn. I started as an architect. I didn't start as a fashion designer, and I still don't really call myself a fashion designer. The work's very interdisciplinary. I started working with 3D printing back in 2007, and I did a bicycle rack for the New York City Department of Transportation. It was part of an initiative to encourage cycling in the city. And then gradually I started to migrate into product design, became more and more interested in the body, started doing wearable pieces. The fashion industry wasn't really using computing. They weren't using any computer-driven design methodologies. So we started running educational programs, and the first one was called New Skins. And that was when we did the first dress on the MakerBot, and it was called the Verlon dress. And we were working with the flexible filament. All of my work has very complex geometry. There was a lot to learn in that first dress. But I think in this next dress, I was able to design for the technology a lot more easily. I knew what I was getting into when we started. This is called the Bristle Dress. There's two main parts to the dress. The lower part is it's printed in the flexible filament, and it was printed flat, so we'd get a really smooth finish. We worked with it more in the sense of traditional pattern making. We'd modeled the skirt in 3D in the computer, and we unrolled it. And then we applied the patterns, and we made the printer files. The upper part of the dress is this sort of big volume. It's this cloud-like, translucent, sort of like haze. You know, it worked really well, and it complemented the body and it moved across the body. It's really about thinking about how to engage the silhouette of the body. And in this case, we really wanted to bleed the body into the atmosphere. We're starting to learn how to work with the technology. I think there's a misconception that you press print, you get whatever's in the computer, but there's still a materiality. And I think it's a materiality that designers need to learn and become acquainted with. I always call it like a language. There's a new kind of formal language and a new language of manufacturing, and every tool has limits. This has far less limits than any other tool I've ever used. But there's still limits, and there's a tendency towards a certain kind of formal language that I think we're still exploring and discovering.